Hello students, today we are going to start with the revision of the chapter power sharing. Power sharing itself means sharing of power. Power here refers to authority. And in political science, we will talk about how the government should share the authority of ruling. Clear? Power should not be concentrated in one hand only. So according to the chapter, first of all, we will study the example of Belgium. Belgium is a small country in Europe which is inhabited by people who speak Dutch, French and German. Or we can say that it has a complex ethnic composition. It so happened that those people who were numerically less in number were rich and powerful, and this was resented by the other communities. Therefore, there was a certain discontent in the society. So to overcome this problem, the Belgian government thought of a very good model, and it adopted such a model that till date the country did not face any upheavals and the people are living peacefully. So to this model we say that accommodation in Belgium. The constitution of Belgium was modified or amended 4 times from 1970 to 1993. As a result, such provisions were added which could satisfy all the communities. One very brilliant feature which the Belgian government added was the introduction of community government. Though when we see the Belgian model, it looks a little complex, but it continues to function very smoothly. Now the second example is of Sri Lanka. In Sri Lanka, the Sinhala community, after independence in 1948, the Sinhala community came to dominate and it started adopting majoritarianism measures, and as a result, the Tamils, those who were the natives and those who had shifted from India, were discontented. Their various proposals to the government fell to the deaf ears. The government adopted such measures that one after the other, the supremacy of Sinhalas were imposed on the other minority communities in Sri Lanka. As a result of general discontent, there was a civil war, as a result of which Sri Lanka had to suffer and thousands of people were killed and there were huge economic losses. Now the next important topic is that why power sharing is desirable. We have studied two examples of Sri Lanka and Belgium. We have seen that if power was shared, what were the consequences? Consequences were positive. Clear? That is, the result were positive. And if power was not shared, like in Sri Lanka, then the consequences were negative and the whole country had to face it. So there are two main factors which we count, that is the prudential and the moral reasons. Prudential reasons means that we need to critically analyze, think over the problem and find a suitable solution. If a suitable solution is found in well in time, then the population lives peacefully and the government can also function peacefully. But if it isn't, then the consequences can be different. Similarly, moral reasons. moral reasons why? Because there can be certain things which are not written in the provisions, or the constitution is not there, or the constitution is silent over certain things. But because since we are democratic countries, clear? So there are certain moral responsibilities with the government that it should consult those over whom it is ruling. And some division of power should be handed over to those, that is to the basic root level. Let's take example of India. By taking example of India, we can tell that in India, the power is shared in various forms. So the first among that is among various organs of the government. Various organs of the government mean that the power is divided in such a way that the legislature, executive, and the judiciary do not impose their will on each other. And we already have studied that India has an independent and integrated judiciary. The second is the, and this is called as the horizontal division of power. Second is the division of power at different levels, and this is called as the vertical division of power. In the vertical division of power, the power is divided among the union or the center, the state, we have the local governments, and India, we have the government at the village level also, or the panchayats. Next is among different social groups. Social groups means those linguistic and religious groups which might not be having, or which are in minority in the society, also need to be given an adequate representation. As the Indian constitution makes a provision for the marginalized communities and the women in various spheres. The next is the power sharing among political parties, pressure groups, and the movements. Political parties, we all know that the people who have a same ideology, they come together, make an organization, and when they fight for the elections and their party wins, they form the government. Clear? We have regional and national parties. Pressure groups are those which give support to the political parties from outside, and movements. Movements are those organizations which arise, keep on arising in the society from time to time. Certain issues arise in the society. So to tackle those issues, these movements are organized. These can be temporary organizations. Once the idea behind which this organization is formed, or whatever goal they have decided is fulfilled, these can be dissolved, or if the issue is persistent, it continues, so these organizations can continue to work. So this was the chapter of power sharing, and we learned that how important it is to share power. Share power means that authority should not be concentrated in one hand. Thank you.